Okay guys, this is the second property of the day. We have just got the keys for this property as well. The team are in there and they are beginning their works. This is a perfect example of the Brrrr strategy, where you buy, renovate, refinance and rent out and pull out the initial funds you would have put into the deal. To give you the top figures, we bought this for £46,000 and we're going to spend about £7,000 to £8,000 remodeling the property, and we should have an end value of about 75 once we are done. This is based in Durham, about a stone throw away from the new Amazon depot as well as Durham city center. It's an area we've never previously invested in, but because of the developments in the area, we've taken a second look, and I think there's demand and potentially increase in value in the coming years. Within a couple of weeks or so, we'll be back at this property, so remember to subscribe and you can see the finished product. Hi, I'm Michael Kosmas. I'm back here at the Durham property that I showed you a couple of weeks ago in my other video. Today, I'm just gonna quickly run through some of the lessons we have learned on this particular project. I like to document most of the lessons and the things that happen on each property project so that it informs how we do business in the future, and it more or less improves you as an investor. So I would encourage you, as a first lesson, if you are investing in property, journal everything and document all the lessons you learned. Make sure that you keep a track of all of the numbers and how you performed on each property, so that way you can better inform how you do business in the future. With this particular property, we are just at the end of the renovation project. There are a few snagging jobs that are left to be done, but I thought to just give you a run through so that you get an understanding of the process, as well as learn some lessons that I have also learned on this project and on many other projects we have done. First of all, to just give you a recap, remember we purchased this property at auction for £46,000. This was quite a dated property. The owner had not been in this house for quite a while. Then it went through probate, the process of which someone who has passed away, their estate is accounted for and then sold at an appropriate price through the probate system. So we got this property and it needed a lot of work done, and we had put a budget of between £7,000 to £9,000. We put a range like that just mainly because on initial assessment, when you are viewing auction properties, you might have to view 20 to just buy 3 or 4, and we tend to buy properties like this in a great amount of quantity. So therefore our performance, we don't necessarily just judge it on one particular property, but we more or less judge our performance over a portfolio or over a number of property that we would have done over a period of time. Because with some property from auction, you will find that actually, you know what, there are no surprises and you don't have to spend as much as you thought. And then with other properties, you will have to spend just a little bit more to get it to a standard that you require. With this property, one of the key things that we had to do was to rewire the property so that way it complies with the current required electrical standards in the UK. As part of that, it meant that we had to spend an extra £2,000 in sorting out the electricals than what we had initially budgeted for. So therefore, lesson number one to learn when you're doing auction property is that always allow a significant contingency when you are doing these type of projects in comparison to properties that you buy on the open market. So the first thing is make sure that you allow a significant margin of error. I would even go as far as to say maybe even up to 15 to 20% of your budget should be allocated to contingencies that may come up as part of your property refurb. That's lesson number one. Lesson number two came from the fact that we were able to bring this project and get it done within 5 weeks time from the time we purchased it from auction. This goes down to the ability of the team that I work with to plan and make sure that we line up all the contractors as the moment we purchase a property. One of the greatest challenges when doing a refurb project like this is to get the right contractors to do the job within the time that you require. As a property investor, you do not want to be holding a property empty for 3, 4, 5 months while you're paying the mortgages as well as the council tax and all the other associated holding costs. So we make sure that our first priority is to make sure that we get all of our contractors lined up. Even if the contractor that we usually use is not available, I am not afraid to go out there and find someone else who can do the job within the time frame we require, so that that way we bring the project in at 5 weeks instead of maybe 8 or 12 weeks waiting for another contractor to come in. Of course, that comes along with its own risks, that you might not get the right person. But if you are working in a location where you have agents and contacts, utilize the people around you who can give you references on this tradesman who you might bring in to work for you for the first time. So the lesson there, line up your contractors so that you can get your project done quicker than later, so that that way you don't have to pay the extra cost of holding the property, and you can bring that property back to market, whether you're selling it or you're letting it out. The third lesson I would take away from this particular project is that never be afraid to put your rental price right in the high end of the market after a thorough refurbishment of your project. Because you'll be surprised, there are some people out there who would want to rent that property even if it's slightly priced higher than normal. Within this area, the properties like this 2 to 3 bedroom houses, they go for $450, $475. But we decided to put it on the market for £500 per month, with the view that if you do not get any interest, you can simply reduce the price. And on that basis, we put it on the market for the first day, and we had an interest, and within the second day, someone had already put in a deposit to hold it at that particular price. So never be afraid to push that little bit more to get that price that you want, whether you're renting or you're selling, and then you adjust things as you go along. So these are some of the quick lessons I think you can take away from this particular project and apply to your own property investment journey. This is one of the many properties that we do on a day-to-day basis. I actually wasn't around for this refurb, so I really have to thank the team that was around this refurb and making sure that it was delivered to this particular standard and time frame. So keep it locked on this channel, subscribe as I share more videos of my property journey. Hopefully you will learn something and you will also pick up a few tips to make your investment journey that much easier and that much more informed. I'll see you next time.